just again, as that is starting, if you not yet onto our WhatsApp group and want to join the WhatsApp group, the link is in the chat now. Okay, so let's start with tonight's session. Basically, tonight we're going to look at a discrete probabilities. So in discrete probability, we're going to look at basically the random discrete, binomial, and Poisson distributions. So in binomial and Poisson, very important nearly that you have access to the binomial and Poisson tables, because that will come in very handy. I think it was part of it is in the study guide, but it is also part of that TUT 101 letter. It was shared in there as well, because we're definitely going to use that in tonight's session. Okay, so let me just, I just want to get to the study guide, so that when we need to look at it, I have it open. Okay, cool. Okay, so basically in tonight's session, we're going to look at defining what a discrete probability is. The same for binomial distributions, the same for Poisson distribution, and then with all three of them, important also to look at how to work out the expected value and how to work out the variance of that distribution as well. So it might be, and not sure if the second quiz is open yet, but you guys can later on test if the second quiz is open, but it might be, and we'll check again in some of the examples tonight, that they can ask you in a question to work out the probability, and then they can ask you nearly to work out the expected value and the variance as well. So they can ask that for the discrete, for the binomial, and for Poisson, so that they nearly in each question already test two or three concepts of that distribution. So just important, we're going to look at all three. So it's the discrete, the binomial, and the Poisson distribution. So what I just added again into this one, like last week, is the wordings, because they will use it again in different questions. And then just remember that we deal with probabilities. So two things of probabilities that will be dealt with in all probabilities is that probabilities can be anything between 0 and 1. And then when you add up the probabilities, it will add up to 1. Okay, so that is again still relevant with the discrete probabilities. So for all three of them, discrete, binomial, and Poisson, remember the probabilities will add to one. So let me show you something in the table. So I am going to the Tut Letter 101. And on there around, what is it, page 6 and 7, the normal distribution, chi-square, we will get it in chapter 10. Okay, so binomial distribution, so that we will use, and then Poisson distribution that we will use tonight. So just as a simple example, if you add, and let's quickly, where was that one. So if you add these three together, the 0,9801, 0,0198, 0,0001, if you add all of them together, your answer will be 1. Okay, if you go to the table here, where n is equal to 20, 0,01, and you add all of these together, again, probability of all the probabilities added together needs to be 1. When we go to Poisson distribution, exactly the same. If you add all of these together, you will get 1. Even if the lambda is 5 and you add all of them together, that will also be equal to 1. So nearly just wanted first to show it doesn't matter which probability we use, Poisson or binomial, it must add to 1. Okay, so that is important in some of the tables that we will get, in some of the questions that we will answer, because again, if one knows it adds to 1, there's certain things that you can subtract from it and do certain things with it. Okay, then that first one we don't need to worry about. So let me just put that block in. So we're only looking at binomial and Poisson, and then I added the discrete distribution as well, so that you know nearly how the general definition looks like. So if we need to work out the mean or the variance or standard deviation. In your textbook and your study guide, you will get the formula for Poisson distribution and binomial distributions. You get how we will work out the mean or the expected value, and you get how we will work out the variance. The big difference between binomial and Poisson is basically binomial is always a choice of two, so if it works or not, so failure or success, it's always the nearly will it work, will it not work, where Poisson will always be a time limit to it or a time period. So, and I will highlight that in all the Poisson questions as well. It will normally tell you in a week, in minutes, in days, in years. So there will always be a time reference to the binomial, to the Poisson distribution, where for binomial it's always a success or failure. So it's always working or not working. And we will see in the questions as well when we get to it. The questions are also normally structured as a failure or a success or something broke or didn't break, or so it is always nearly anchored around that. Okay, the other important thing is remember stats is open book, so you don't need to study off by heart the definitions and the formulas. Closer to the exam time, I am in any case also going to share with you a full write-up of the formulas and things that you can print it, have it with you. So don't worry about that. It's more about how do you nearly use the, and let's be honest, if it is very time consuming to use the formulas. So if I need to work out a probability, please tell me it's being recorded. Yes, it is recorded. No, it is recorded, so I will share. Don't worry. It is recorded. So if you get to, let's say, Poisson distribution, and imagine you need to work out one of the Poisson questions with using the formula, and you needed to work out, let's say, that if you're not using the table, you will need to make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 nearly sums to get to your answer. And that, if we time limited, that's not something that you really want to do if we can avoid it. So I'm definitely going to show you guys how to use the tables, so that we can really, in certain of the things, nearly give you back time when you're doing it in the exam, so that again you will, your assignment is normally a bit longer in time that you have, but your exam is, if it is like last year, it is shorter than what you are getting to complete the assignments. So I really want to show you guys how to use the tables for binomial and for Poisson. Okay, so let's let's start. And the first question nearly talks to the question of all probabilities that needs to add to one. So which one of the following statements is a valid probability distribution? So please see if you can look through it and see which one is the correct one. And in the chat, you can just say 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Okay, so let's look at it. So by giving me a discrete table in each one of them, we know that from probabilities, your probability that the sum of the probabilities needs to be equal to 1. Okay, so let's look at the first one. 0.512 plus 0.384 plus 0.096 plus 0.008. Okay, so if I add all of these together, I get 1. So 1 is correct. Let's look at the other ones. 0.1 plus 0.4. 0.1 plus 0.3 is 0.4. Plus 0.4 is 0.8. Plus that one, so that is 0.9. So that one is not. 0.01, 0.01, 0.01 plus 0.98, so that is equal to 1.01. So it's not that one. If I look at this one, that is equal to 0.99. Again, not one, even though it's close, it's not one. And then this one is 0.5, 0.8, 1.2, if I added it correctly. So again, not equal to 1. So the one that is correct is the one where all the probabilities add to 1. Okay, so that is from that definition that we nearly have on all probabilities. So it doesn't matter, again, if it is discrete, binomial, Poisson, normal distribution, when we get to that, chi-square distributions, when we get to that. So all probabilities must be equal or add to 1. Okay, so nearly a combination of looking at discrete plus that traditional kind of definition. Okay, so now we go into a bit more detail of the discrete distribution. And this is the one where, okay, so there are certain criteria that we need to look at. They ask us to work out the expected value as well. Okay, so let's look at this, and I always like to draw this so that one can really see how to look at it. And they ask us which one is correct. Okay, so x bigger or equal to 2. So x bigger or equal to 2. And so it is x2 x3, x4. So if you add all of those together, you get that it's not that one, that is 0.7. Okay, so if you add all of those together, you will get 0.7 and not 0.2. Okay, so that is not the correct one. So let's use a different color for the next probability. X smaller or equal to 1. Okay, so smaller or equal to 1 is these two. So smaller than 1 is 0 and equal to 1 is just 1. So 0.1 plus 0.2 is 0.3. So that is wrong. It must be 0.3. Okay. We're going to leave the expected one for last because there we need to do a bit more calculations. So let's look at green. Smaller or equal to 4. It's a smaller or equal to 4, but bigger than 1. Okay, so we're looking at that space. So you can see what was asked in the purple and asked in the green is exactly the same, but asked way different. But you can see it is exactly the same component that we're looking for. That one is correct because it is 0.7, but what I wanted to show you guys is with this, we actually, those two, we're looking at exactly the same answer, but phrased totally different. Let's get to the last one. So x smaller than 4, but bigger than 2. So x smaller than 4, bigger than 2 is only x equal to 0. So that is also wrong because that is 0.15. Okay, so that is how we would have worked out the probabilities of a discrete distribution. How we will work out the expected value. So the expected value is basically the sum of x times the probability of that x. So what I will normally do is if I've got a table like this, I will say, okay, 0 times 0.1 is 0. 1 times 0.2 is 0.2. 2 times 0.5 is 1. 3 times 0.15 is 0.45. Plus 4 times 0.05, I think it's 0.2, but let me just make 100% sure. 4 times 0.05, yes. And if we add all of that together, the 0.2 plus the 0.45 plus 1 plus 0.2, we get 1.85. So it was the same numbers, but this one was 18.5. It should have been 1.85. So again, that one would have so shown it is incorrect. Okay, but the most important thing here nearly for me was to show you that they can phrase the question. It seems totally different, but it's actually referencing the same values that we're looking for. So really important for me is this link between these two. And we will see it in other questions as well, where they can phrase the question just a bit differently, and you get maybe the same outcome. Okay, so let's look at another question like this. So here they give us all of the discrete variables. They tell us the x and the probability of each one. And here they only ask us to work out what is the mean expected value. Okay, so that is what we need to work out, is the mean expected value. So again, what I would do is I will just, like the previous one, multiply out and then add it. A zero times that will be zero. 1 times 0.2 is 0.2. 2 times 0.1 is also 0.2. 3 times 0.05 is 0.15. 4 times 0.03 is 0.12. 5 times that is 0.05. And 6 times that is 0.06. And if we add all of that together, that is our expected value. So it will be 0.2 plus 0.2 plus 0.15 plus 0.12 plus 0.05 plus 0.06, which will give us 0.78, which is option 3. Okay, so the thing with working out the expected value, it's very difficult to nearly get a feel if or what the answer might be. When we get to binomial and Poisson, it is going to be a bit different, but it's very difficult to in these to nearly get a feel of what your expected value is going to be. So it's some of the other things where sometimes an answer that you can nearly say it's not going to be this or it's not going to be that. But when you look at your expected values and your variances and standard deviations, very difficult nearly to say it's definitely not this number or it's definitely not this number. So with, again, I did not have a feel at all of what the number is going to be. So just also it, and you guys will see some of the questions also that we will cover tonight. Some of it is you nearly get the feel of that just might be one of the correct options, but with this, very difficult to get something. Okay, so this one was for me interesting. So here they tell you if the mean is 2.52, what is the variance for this distribution? So let's quickly go back to that formula. And let's see, okay, so it's still, if we want to work this out, It is that we will need to say the one minus the other one to the power of two. So if I look at this, I now need to say that one minus the mean to the power of two times, and we nearly go on with it. So again, I need to minimum five possible. So I would, again, just for the calculations, use Excel. Not, there is not a function in here that you can work it out with. So, but just to put in the numbers to just work it out a bit easier. Yes, you allowed to use calculator to work it out. You can use the tables, or if you want to write it down as a table, you can do that as well. But for me, it's just for me simpler to use a bit of Excel for this. So I'm also just going to show you, so let's put in this formula. Into that, and I will share the Excel spreadsheet with you as well on the chat, that you guys have that. So I just want to quickly do that. Okay, so let's first work out the mean. They did tell us it is, what was it, 2.52, but let's work it out according to the formula. So it is, the mean is that x times the probability. Let's write that as is. So if we add all of those together, it should be the 2.52. Then we say, to work out the variance, we take that value minus the mean. We need to square root that. Square root that, and then we multiply it by the probability. Okay, so that is again quite a long task for you to do. And if we then sum that, because it is the sum of that, we get the variance is equal to 29.91. So we can say that is the variance. So let's just quickly go back and see what they wanted us to work out. If a mean is that, then the variance of a best student in, okay, that's interesting. That should have stayed the same. I was subtracting other numbers, so let's see if it changes. But there's still not the answer for that. I can remember. Okay, so where did we also That's where x, x minus the mean to the power of 2 . So column C was, oh, thank you. Let's just check. Okay, so my formula was wrong. Thank you for that. So my formula should be, it's for 1. Minus the mean . I did it the other way around, and that multiplied by that probability, sorry, yeah, thanks for that. Okay. That looks much better to what a lot of the answers was. So now it will be 1,649. So that is, let's, 1.6496. Okay, so what you can do now with, when I sent the Excel, you can change. So if you now change the probabilities and the x's, it will automatically change your answer set here, so that you can use it for other problems as well. So if, let's say that changed to 1.15, that changed to 1.17, then you can see automatically your answers are adjusting to what it is. So I will share this with you guys, so that if you want to use it as a page for discrete, you can use it. Let's say,
Hi Jean, can you please click on the 0.578? I want to see the formula.
Yeah, so it is the x minus the mean. So if you look at that, it's the x minus the mean to the power of 2 times the probability. So okay. This,
thank you.
The second one will then be the x, that's 2 minus the mean to the power of 2 times the probability that goes with the 2. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so, much.
And so it goes. So, and that's again, so it just again nearly use what you are comfortable with. If the Excel helps you, use it. But if you don't like Excel and you want to use, you can also just write it down. So what I normally would do again is they've given us the mean, so that at least is something that you don't. So how you could have worked it out is just to say, the 1 minus the mean to the power of 2 times that probability plus this. exercise again. Plus when we go to the second one, 2 minus 2.52 to the power of 2 times, then it would be 0.33. And we do need to do that for all 5 of them, and we add that together, and we will get then the variance. Okay, so let's look at the next one. So those first few was on discrete. So sometimes they tell you you get a binomial distribution. So again, let's quickly look at the next one. So here they don't tell us binomial or Poisson. So again, not. So we're going to check why it is one of the two. Here they told us Poisson. Here they told us. And again, but I will check if there's other things in there that we can also link it to. But so here they tell us we're looking at a binomial distribution where n is equal to 6 and I is equal to 0.2. Okay, so then they also tell us hints, use the formula or the binomial table. So let's n 6. So let's go binomial. Might be that. Okay, so n 6, and so we're looking at that. So I just want to check if I can cut a piece of this out. So let me quickly. So let's do it this way. Okay, cool. So now we can play a bit with the colors as well again. Okay, so we're looking at in 6, pi is 0.2. So we're going to look at this component of the table. Okay, so this component where pi is 0.2, n is 6. So let's look at what they ask us. So let's do that one, and we'll do the color with that. So probability that x is equal to 2. Okay, so let's see, there's x equal to 2. So if I go across, what's the probability that x is equal to 2? It's 0.2458. Okay, that one is correct, but we're looking for incorrect one. Okay, so let's another color. Probability that x is equal to 5. Let's go. Probability x equal to 5. Here we go across. Probability equal to 5, Okay, that is 0,0001. It's not that one.
So isn't that?
Sorry?
It's the one before that one. You are on number six.
Ah, okay, cool. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Awesome. Let's quickly. And I actually have my specs on. I must get stronger spectacles. Cool. 0,0015. Oh, okay. It's still not the same, eh? Yes. Okay. So it's still not correct. Thanks for that. So 0,0015, 0,0005. Okay. So the second option is wrong, but let's still do the others as well, because again, I want to nearly show you all the ways are we. So X smaller or equal to one. So smaller or equal to one is one and zero. So it includes one and it includes zero because it's smaller or equal to one. So that is 0.3932 plus 0.2621, which is 0,6553, which is correct. And then let's do that one as well. So zero comma or x bigger or equal to one. So x bigger or equal to five. So it's five and six. So five and six. So let's rather now just do that. So that is, if you add those two together, you will get the 0,0016. And then the other one was how to work out the mean of a binomial. So if we go back to that, the expected value is n minus p. So your expected value for this one is n minus p. Which is 6 times 0.2. Which is 1.2. Which is that. Okay, so I just wanted to show with the table nearly, and you guys are allowed to have a tables. So when you get the questions, even if it is online, your table is paper based. So you are allowed to scribble on it. You are allowed to highlight. You are allowed to do those things. Just don't make, like I did, a parallax fault, but please, especially this chapter 6-7, where we're gonna use the normal distribution also quite a lot, it helps me a lot to visually see what I'm looking for, so that they don't catch you out with one of these just because you looked at it a bit strangely. Okay, so let's look at the next one, and if we need to put in a table again, we will. A certain type of tomato seed germinates 90% of the time. A backyard farmer plant. That is a bit plant, it should be planted 25 seeds. The expected number of seeds that germinate is. Okay, so we need to get to the expected value. Expected value is N times P. So P is 0.9, the probability. So 25 times 0.9 is 2.25. Okay, which is option one, 2.25. What if they ask you, what is the expected mean of seeds that don't germinate? What would your probability have been for that? So if I ask you not germinate, what would your probability be? Or what will your, let me rephrase that, not your probability, but what will your pi be for that? Oh, sorry. Yes, you're all right. What is wrong with my calculator? 25 times 0.9. Sorry, it is 22.5. Thank you for, I don't know what I did wrong with my calculator. It looked strange, but okay, so it's 22.5. Sorry. And just a way how quick it is to make that mistake, I thought it looked weird, but okay, so 22.5 is your expected values. Thank you for that. It's not 2.25, it's 22.5. Okay, so that was expected value for germinate. So not germinate, how would you get that? So what would your P be for germinate if we needed to say N times P for not germinate? So the N will stay the same, 25. What will that P be? Okay, cool. It is 0.1. Okay. And the reason why 0.1 for the P, because this thing, the seed can happen one thing, it can germinate or not. So it's binomial. So germinate is 0.9. So to not germinate will be 1 minus 0.9, because those two will always add to 1. Okay, so that original answer, yes, it is 22.5 and not 2.25, so it is 22.5. So 25 times 0.9 is definitely 22.5 and not 2.25. I did make a silly mistake on my calculator. The scary thing is I actually got the answer, which is more scary than, yeah. Okay, so just be again careful of what they also ask. They I've seen in previous exam papers where they, especially with light bulbs, they ask this question a lot as well, is how many light bulbs, or they say that 45% of light bulbs break in the manufacturing process, how many light bulbs will not break? Okay, so just be careful with the wordings that they sometimes have, that they give you the information for the one, but sometimes they ask the other one as well. So that's why I just wanted to show you the non-Germanite so that we just don't make that mistake. Okay, let's look at the next question. So again, they don't tell us what it is. So let's read. Suppose that 10% of butterflies have damaged wings. Okay, so again, what we have is butterflies with damaged wings, butterflies with no damaged wings. If a random sample of 10 butterflies is selected, what is the probability that more than 4 have damaged wings? So let's just, and what's the probability that more than 4, so more than 4. Okay, so let's go N 10 pi of P equal to 0.1. So let's check. Okay, there's the 10. Okay, so and 0 comma. So it's gonna be, let's just quickly, I will show you guys now. Just want to copy this piece over so that we have it as well, and it's only the that piece that I want. Okay, so let's just get it a bit bigger. It was something like that, 0.12345678910. Okay. Okay, so let's look at this table. They ask us, what's the probability of X bigger than 4? Okay, so X, there's X4, so X bigger than 4 is from 5. And there isn't, but let's just, so that would have been your X bigger than 4. Okay, so what is the probability that more than 4, more than 4 does not include 4. So 0.0015 plus the 0,0001 gives us the 0,0016, which is option 3. Okay, so if just look, if only X4, one would might have picked that. If you included 4 into it, you can see that plus that would have given you option 2. So if you picked 4 and more, that would have been added. So then you would have gotten option 2. If you have said, well, less than, and said 1 minus that, there is the option for you. And then the last one is probably, don't know if you said 2 or something like that, 2 or 3, but I don't know how one would have gotten to that out of a selection. Okay, so again, use the table. If we now needed to use the definition, we still needed to do 3 or 4 calculations, which just makes using the table a bit easier than using the formula that you have in the study guide and in your textbook. Okay, Poisson distributions. So firstly, let's see the difference of the thing added is the time issue for Poisson. So let's look at what they say. Calculate the probability that 3 bank robberies occurred in a day, where the number of bank robberies that occur in a large Gauteng city is a Poisson distribution per day. Okay, so again, per day. So let's calculate the probability that 3 bank robberies occur in a day. Okay, they give us lambda. Lambda is equal to 1.8. So Poisson distribution, we will use where, so there's the lambda 1.8. So let's just copy this whole one out. So let's copy that lambda part in. Okay, so we're gonna do it where lambda is 1.8. Then I set 3 bank robberies. Calculate the probability that 3 bank robberies occur. 3 bank robberies, 0,1607. Okay, so if I set 3 or more, then we'll add that. If I set less than 3, we will look at the below part. But here, calculate the probability that 3 bank robberies occur. So only 3, it's 0,1607. Okay, so again, to show on the, it's again easier to nearly highlight on the table that part that you need to look for. So even if it was saying less than 3, then if you highlight it, you can see which ones you need to add. If it said more than 3, then also one can see which ones you need to add. So again, I like the visually looking at the table and nearly highlight what what I need to get to. Okay, let's look at another question. So again, Poisson distribution was used to model the number of faults in the gearbox of buses. Suppose the faults occur at the average of 2.5 per month. What is the probability that at least two? Okay, let's put this in. Again, English not my first language, so at least let's see what at least means. And then if we have at least, so let's see, is equal to, is less than, is greater than, more than, fewer than, below, at most, at least. The probability that at least two, at least, so bigger or equal to. So let's just quickly make that a bit smaller that I can still include it so that we can include the table as well. Okay, so there at least means that. So let's go average 2.5. So if the average is 2.5, that means that the lambda is also 2.5, so the lambda and average is exactly the same. So let's go 2.5. So let's take this one. At least, so bigger or equal to at least two. At least two, so all of these, sure. Okay, so that is what we need to add together. So we can do that. We can all add all of that together. Or we could have said, well, I know that all of these must equal to one. So instead of adding all of them together, I'm just going to say one minus these two. Then I will get to the same answer. Okay, because all of the probabilities need to equal to one. So if I add all of this together, it will be one. So you can check if you add all the ones in green, you will get the same to say, but let's say one minus adding the other two.
The answer is 0.7127.
Cool. Okay. Perfect. Great stuff. Say again, 127. Sure. Again, look at this one. How they want to nearly, and again, you can easily make the mistake of going for five, because as you look at your answer, you see the 0.7171 and easily could make that mistake. where they just switch the two numbers around. So very easily one can make that mistake. Okay. And let's look at the last one for tonight. Assume that X is Poisson. So here they don't tell us timing or anything. So they just tell us, okay, lambda is 6. Okay, so let's go to lambda 6. So you can see it becomes really a big table if we now need to start adding all of those numbers. So let's first see what they ask us. Yes, all the sessions are recorded. Let me quickly, it will be added on the Western Cape portal, but also I will post it later tonight on my WhatsApp group. So please, if you're not on the WhatsApp group yet, join the WhatsApp group. I am posting the recording and the presentation and previous recordings on there as well. So it will be on the WhatsApp group. So please, there's a link in the chat now. If you can't get to the link, you can also send me a WhatsApp on 083-790-8387. Okay, so you can do that. Okay, so lambda 6. So let's look at probability that X is equal to 0, 0,0025, 0,0025, correct. Ah, I'm looking for the incorrect one. So next one. Okay, the variance we're going to keep for last. Probability that X is smaller than 3. So smaller than 3 is 2, 1, and 0. Okay, so that is smaller than 3. So it is 0.0446 plus 0.0149 plus 0.0025. So if I add those three together, I do get 0,062. So still not what I want. Okay, so let's look at probability bigger than 5. The probability bigger than 5 will be from 6. So again, we can add all of these, all the ones in blue, or you could have set 1 minus those ones. This one is probably very close to just add the ones together. But either way, we will get to the answer. So I'm adding all the blue ones together, and hopefully not making a mistake while I'm adding. Phew, it's a lot of numbers. I'm getting 0,5543. Cool. So I am getting that. But yeah, it's a lot of numbers. So you can also say 1 minus these ones, which probably is going to be less of work to say 1 minus those 6 numbers instead of adding what was that, nearly 11, 12 numbers. Okay, let's look at then this one. So probability smaller than 5, so smaller than 5 is 4 and 3, but bigger than 2. So you're not including 2, only looking at 3 and 4. So if we add those two together, we get 0.09 or 0.0892 plus 0.1339. So when I add those two together, I get not that one. I get 0.2231. So option 5 is the incorrect one. Now let's just look at the variance. So how do we work out the variance? And let's just show you that formula, then I will go back. So that is interesting. Because that is also wrong. Well, standard deviation is actually equal to x smaller than 5, it is those 2, x bigger than 2, so it is 3 and 4. That's interesting. Let us just quickly check in the study guide, but I am sure the variance is equal to lambda. I just want to make 100% sure. Yeah, the variance is equal to lambda. So this is definitely also wrong. That is equal to the standard deviation. Okay, so this one have two mistakes on it. Okay, so that one is wrong because it is definitely, so let's see if we added the 0.04. I just want to see if there was another mistake. Okay, no, so that one was definitely supposed to be the wrong one. I think here they made the mistake that they wanted to say standard deviation, but instead, so both of them is actually incorrect. Okay, so again, if you look at the Poisson distribution, how to use the table, very, very important. Because again, in your assignment, you will get something like that, as well in the exam. So in the exam, you will get so your assignment is on chapter 4 and 5, so that will cover the probabilities and all of these probabilities. So about 3 questions per topic. So about 3 questions for probability, 3 questions on discrete, 3 questions on Poisson, 3 questions on binomial. That is most likely how it's going to be for your assignment. And in the exam, there's about 1 question of each. So discrete will be 1, Poisson will be 1, binomial will be 1, and most likely study unit 4 on probabilities, there most likely will be 2. So there are in your exam will be about 5 questions around study unit 4 and 5. Yes, question, Lizzie.
Hi, Jean. So if they said they wanted the standard deviation, how would we have to calculate it?
Okay, so to get to the standard deviation, so because that lambda is the variance, you will do exactly as we did with the others, you would say the square root of that 6. So that is how you would get to the standard deviation. So the standard deviation, you would just say the square root of variance. So that principle stays exactly the same. If we want to get to a standard deviation, doesn't matter what we're doing, it's always the square root of the variance.
Okay.
So that is how we will do exactly with this as well. Okay, so standard deviation, always the square root of the variance. So that is also important. If we quickly go back to those formulas, so each of these ones is variances that we have. So if we wanted to get to the standard deviation, so let's put it in. So if we wanted to get to the standard deviation, we needed to say the square root of that NP times 1 minus P. And if we wanted to get the square root of your Poisson, we needed to say square root of the lambda. Okay, so there it is, in and here it is already with your discrete random, we have it already. Okay, so I think that also very nice question, Lizzie, so that we add that into this, that again, because let's be honest, they will ask something about the standard deviations. So one, they can ask standard deviation. One, they can ask, where was it, the mean. One, they can ask the variance. Okay, so what we are going to do is next Thursday, we are going to prep for assignment 2. So next Thursday, we're going to go through chapter 4 and 5 again. I am gonna look at assignment of, I think, 2021 or 2022. We're gonna use that as prep. But again, if anybody else are doing the quiz that is also, I don't know if a quiz is available yet, but if you're going to do the quiz, please send me that questions as well. I will make sure that before you guys need to hand in assignment 2, that we also go through that quiz. So if somebody does the quiz and can then share it with me, the questions afterwards, that will also be great, because then we can use that as prep for your second assignment as well. Yes, there's a hand.
Hello, everyone. Sorry for coming late. This is my first session, so I just wanted to ask a few things. Is this the official UNISA is it classes, or is this like an external class? I think let me just ask that question first before I ask my follow-up.
Okay, so I am a tutor at UNISA, so it is sponsored by UNISA.
Okay.
So,
you're one of the tutors, right?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, I got a after the first assessment, I got a intervention assessment, intervention class. I was come for this.